Head.
Thank you, Glenn. Hey, you know what they say about any challenge? The hardest part is taking the first step. Well, thank goodness we've got a little boost to your Monday this morning. Gonna kick it off with some new shoes and Lori Patterson with Boot Camp Challenge.
That's right.
You know what it's all about when it comes to challenge. It's spring, 5K season. We need these bad boys.
We do. And first of all, I love your excitement. Thank you for being excited about running. When I tell my campers we're about to run, they're like, oh, so thank you for your enthusiasm. Is that fake enthusiasm?
No, not at all. Maybe it's enthusiasm because I know I'm actually not going to be running. But one day.
Okay, but one day. And when you do, you're going to take these tips so that you be super fast and healthy.
Actually, producer Tom, he's running for me.
Is
he? 9.5.
Oh,
I could
perfect.
Maybe bring him
these might work. Awesome.
Yeah.
But you were so
he's
right. Your first step.
He's burning calories. It's our partnership.
That's awesome. He's working out for you. Is the first step when you start a running program is your shoes. So many different brands. These are just two right here. These are Hoka's. These are Adidas. I have on Brooks. The best thing to do, Lisa, is go to a shoe store and get fitted because sometimes you pronate or so your heel will roll in or your heel will roll out. Or you have a neutral. So you first want to find what your foot strike is because shoes are made accordingly.
Oh.
And you're going to get a pair of shoes. Both my, these are my our old ones actually, and we're neutral strike. But how you can tell on your own accord is if you flip over your tennis shoes and look. So if you have a worn edge right here, then you know that you're pronating or your heel's rolling in. And then if you're worn out here, then you're supinating. So that would also give you an indicator when you go into a shoe store on what type of shoes to do. So you definitely want to do that. Also, socks are super important. And I always suggest find one that you like best. So like I like this where there's just nothing on my ankle. Husband likes it where they're just a little bit higher up. And then you can even get them where they come up above the ankle. So that really is about your level of comfort. And obviously you want to make sure that you get running socks. You want to stay away from cotton.
Yeah, I like those short ones, but I hate when they fall off, you know, and get in my tennis shoe. But I've realized socks really are, they can make a difference.
They can make a huge difference. And it's so funny, I bought a whole pack and started wearing them, I won't say the brand, and they were off my heel within a minute. So I went and got these rock, and they're nice and tight, they're snug right here. And then lastly,
I was gonna say this.
This is a training schedule. So a lot of people get really excited, like, oh, I'm gonna do my first 5K, and I'm like, yes, go. But there is a science and a process to prepare for a race. Oh, this is actually a half marathon. I should have printed out a 5K.
Setting big goals.
But if you do it this way and then don't forget to stretch and then strengthen like your inner thighs and outer thighs, you're gonna stay healthy through the whole training process and then have a great race.
Right, because I did none of those things when I first started running a couple years ago, and then I hurt my knee really bad, and it's been really hard to get back into
and
it.
And that's what happens with so many people, and they get so excited and they're exuberant, which is awesome, but they don't have any kind of guidelines or know to get new shoes. And here's another thing, when you're training, Lisa, and you're running, you're probably gonna need new shoes after 3 to 4 months, not a year. Because they go by mileage, not
Tom, you need new shoes. Write that down. Guys, listen to her. Lori Patterson with Boot Camp Challenge, bootcampchallenge.com. There's a hyphen in there, right?
Yes, bootcampchallenge.com.
Listen to her. She knows everything. Don't go to me for workout tips. Maybe one day.
But you're very excited about
it. Yes. Stay with us. I'm also excited about the 9 a.m. Here's what's coming up.